अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अगेन टुडेज टॉपिक इज परसेंटेज चेंज एंड आई एम डूइंग क्वेश्चन नंबर 12 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 8B. द प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट ऑफ अ प्रिंटर कंसिस्ट ऑफ cost of raw materials at $100, the cost of overheads $80, and wages at $120. So we are given a printer whose cost will be obtained by adding the cost of raw materials, cost of overheads and wages. Another thing which is given, if the cost of raw materials and overheads are increased by 11% and 20% respectively, if the cost of raw materials are increased by 11% and overheads are increased by 20%, while wages are decreased by 15%, and what we have to find, the percentage increase or decrease. So first of all, I will find production cost of the printer. Before any change, production cost of a printer, cost of raw material $100, cost of overheads $80, and wages will be added to get the production cost of the printer. $300. As we have to find percentage increase or decrease, so we will find increase in raw materials, increase in overheads and decrease in wages. Increase in raw materials 11%. As we are increasing raw materials, so 11% will be of raw materials cost $100, it will be $11. Now increase in overheads, overheads are increased by 20%. As we are increasing overheads, so percentage will be of overheads, which was originally $80. $16. Now wages are decreased by 15%. 15% of wages originally, which was $120, If I add both the increase, it will be more than the decrease. So overall, change in the production cost of the printer will be increased. As we have to find the percentage increase, so numerator will be increase, and increase will be obtained by adding both the increase in overheads and raw materials and by subtracting wages, as we are decreasing wages, which is $18, and denominator will be the original production cost of the printer, which was $300. Now by using calculator, numerator will become 9 and units will be cancelled out. Again by using calculator, we will get 3% increase. 3% increase means out of every 100 of the original cost of the printer, there is $3 increase. Now I do question number 11. In question number 11, in 2011, a train carried 8% more passengers than in 2010. 2011 is related with 2010. In the third line, in 2012, it carried 8% more passengers in 2011. 2012 is related with 2012. And what we have to find? Find the percentage increase in the number of train passengers from 2010 to 2012. An interesting thing is that we are not given the number of passengers in any of the year, 2010, 2011, 2012. So firstly, I will let number of passengers carried by a train in 2010 is X. Let number of passengers carried by a train in 2010 is X, then in 2011 will be 100% plus 8% of 2010's passengers. As in 2011, a train carried 8% more passengers than in 2010. Passengers are more than 2010's passengers, so we will take percentage of passengers of 2010, which is X. It will become 108%. Multiplied by X over 100, 1.08X. In 2012, it carried 8% more passengers than in 2011. So in 2012, passengers will become 100% plus 8%. As 8% more than in 2011, so percentage will be of 2011. Hundred percent plus 8% of passengers in 2011, which is now 1.08x. Multiplied by 1.08x over 100. Now by using calculator, x will be as it is, 1.1664 x. And what we have to find? Find the percentage increase in the number of passengers carried by a train from 2010 to 2012. So firstly, I will find increase by subtracting smaller number from the larger number, and we have to find the percentage increase in the number of train passengers. In 2010, passengers is X. In 2012, passengers is 1.1664X. So it is more than the X. 1.1664X minus X. It can be written as 1 into X. Now by taking common X and by using calculator, we will get 0.1664X. Now I will find its percentage increase. Increase will be numerator, and as we have to find the percentage increase from 2010 to 2012, so number of passengers of previous year 2010 will be the denominator, which is X. Increase will be numerator. X will be cancelled out. We will get 16.64%. And 16.64 shows that out of every 100 of number of passengers of 2010, there will be an increase of approximately 17 passengers in 2012. Now I do question number 16. In question number 16, we are given Amira is 8% taller than Vixian. Amira's height is related with Vixian. And Priya is 10% shorter than Vixian. Priya's height is related with Vixian. An interesting thing is, we are not given the height of any of the person. So as Amira's height and Priya's height is related with Vixian, so I will let it out, Vixian's height be X. So let us suppose that Vixian's heights be X units. Units are not given, so we can write only units. Amira is 8% taller than Vixian. So Amira will be 108% of the height of Vixian. So Amira's height will be 100% plus 8% of Vixian's height, which is X. 108% of X. 108X over 100. 1.08X. And Priya is 10% shorter than Vixian. So Priya's height will be 100% minus 10% of Vixian's height, as 10% is less than of Vixian height. Of Vixian's height, which is X, 100% माइनस 10% विल बी 90%. It will become 90x over 100 by using calculator 0.9x. Express the height of Amira as a percentage of that of Priya. So Amira's height will be numerator and Priya's height will be denominator. Then we will multiply with 100% to get the required percentage. Express the height of Amira as a percentage. We have to find the percentage of Amira. So Amira's height will be numerator. As a percentage of that of Priya's height, so Priya's height will be denominator. Multiplied by 100%. Now by replacing the values of Mira's height, 1.08x, Priya's height 0.9x, x will be cancelled out, and by using calculator we will get 120%. Thank you, students.